हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज सुब्रत घोष। एज यू नो, मीडियन मीन्स मिडिल। इट मीन्स द नंबर व्हिच इज इन द मिडिल ऑफ द होल ऑब्जर्वेशन इज मीडियन, और इन शॉर्ट वी कैन से मीडियन इज ए मिडिल नंबर इन ए ग्रुप ऑफ नंबर्स। दिस मे also be indicated as middlemost value. From our last class, we have seen that when all the observations are arranged or sorted in ascending or descending order, the middlemost value is the median for the discrete series. But today we will be learning how median is calculated for the continuous series or the observations having class interval or class boundary. For that we would be using something different formula and the formula is, this is the formula of median for the continuous series, and each and every term has different interpretation. Like L1, it has different interpretation, N by 2 has interpretation, C, I and FM. Now we will elaborate the formula step by step. Now closely you look at the formula. This is the formula of median for continuous series. Okay. Now we are going to elaborate each and every term of the formula. You have seen the formula? Okay. Now, again, coming to the formula. What the formula shows you? L1. What does L1 interpret? L1 is the lower boundary of the median class. What the lower class boundary? That I will explain you later. And this N, what is N here? N is same, sum of frequency or summation of frequency. What is C here? C is the cumulative frequency of the class before median class. It means we have to find out, firstly we have to find out the median class. Then what is the cumulative frequency before that median class would be the C. And what is FM here? FM is the frequency of the median class. And what is I here? I is the size of the median class interval. This is the formula of median of a continuous series where L, N, C, FM and I, all the different terms have their different meaning or interpretation. So firstly, we have to locate where the median value lies in the class interval or class boundary. For that, first and foremost thing is to calculate the value of this N by 2. Firstly, we have to find out this N by 2. Then we can find other values. Now we will explain it by an example or problem. Okay. Firstly, what you have to do? Firstly, from the problem, we have to find out N by 2. Then we have to check where the median lies, in which class interval or class boundary. Then other thing like L1, C, FM and I, that will be calculated. Okay, now see the problem. Suppose we have this problem. This is our problem, that calculate the median for the following data. Now see, class interval is given and also frequency f is given. I think you have seen the problem. Now you see, how will you calculate the median? Okay, here in the problem this class interval is given. If you closely look at the problem, 1, 3, it is 4, 6, there is a gap is there, 3 and 4. Similarly here 4, 6, 7, 9, one gap is there. To get the better approximate or to get the better average, better to convert this class interval into class boundary. In the case of median, if the observations are continuous class intervals, then there is no problem. But if there is a discontinuity is there, better make it continuous to get the better approximate. You can use directly, you can use this one also, but if you convert it into class boundary or make it continuous, then the result would be more approximate. That is why we will convert it into class boundary. This is the, let us see, this is the problem. This is the problem. Okay, class interval is there. What we will do? We will convert it into continuous or class boundary. So what is that? It is 1, 3. So what is the gap here? 3 and 4. What is the gap? Gap is 1. Then what we will do? We will make it continuous. Then we will subtract 0.5 here and plus, and we will add up 0.5 here. What will be this? This will be 0.5. Here will be 3.5. It is what? 0.5 less. It will be 3.5. It will be 6.5. Here it will be 7.5 less. 6.5 minus 9.5. Same way, it is 10.5 less. 9.5. It is 12.5. Same way, it is 13.5 less. 12.5 minus 15.5. It is 16.5 less. The 15.5 minus 18.5. It is 19.5 minus 0.5 less. It will be 18.5 minus here 0.5 will be added. It is 21.5. Okay, see. Now see, this is continuous. 3.5, 3.5, 6.5, 6.5, it is 9.5, it is 9.5, it is 12.5, 12.5, it is 15.5, now it is continuous. You can directly use this class interval also, but if you make it a continuous, then the result would be more approximate than using this one. Now another thing is what? And this is finding the CF. CF means cumulative frequency. How to do that? Now see, it is 5, so it is 5. It is what? 5, 10, 15. It is what? 12. 15 plus 12. How much? 27. 27 plus 35. How much it is? 62. Then 20, 82. Then 17 plus. Then plus 9, 108. This is in this way, cumulative frequency is calculated. This is 5, 5 plus 10, 15, 15 plus 12, 27, 27 plus 35, 62, 62 plus 20, 82, 82 plus 70, 99, 99 plus 110. So this is 110. And also, this frequency, if you add up the frequency, it will come 110. This is also the can also be called as checkpoint. So the if this 110 last cumulative frequency and the sum of frequency is same, then you are going right. Okay. Now see, closely look this. Look at this. So what I have done, I have converted it into a continuous from class interval to class boundary. Then I have added up all the frequency, this n summation f 110. Now also I have calculated the cumulative frequency. Okay now so we will get this fresh table for this problem. You see the table. This is the calculation. Okay. This is the class interval. This is class boundary. This is frequency. This is cumulative frequency. Okay, now what I told you earlier, to get the median, our first and foremost task is to find the n by 2. What is n here? N is 110. What is the first work? First task is to get the n by 2. Is n by 2? N by 2 is what? N by 2 is what? 108 by 2 goes to 54. Now we have to see, locate where the median lies. 54. We have to check it from the cumulative frequency. Okay? So where the 54 lies? Now see, it is 5. The 54 is much larger value than 5. 15, here also 54 does not lie. 27, it is also 54 does not lie. Now 62. You see 62? This 62, here 54 lies. So this is our median class. Now our focus will be here. It means speed, it means frequency will be in between this. Okay, now what is this? Now from this we'll, what we'll get? This is the lower class boundary. Okay, this is lower class boundary 9.5. This is frequency of the median class. Okay, this is frequency of the median class, and this is what? This is here median lies. It means C is what? This is C. Why it is C? Because what is our formula? C means the cumulative frequency preceding the median class. It is the median class. Preceding means before the median class. So this is the median class. just before of that cumulative frequency is 27. So from here, what we have got? This is L1, this is FM, this is C, this is N by 2, and what is the gap? 9.5, 12.5. What is the gap is there here? 3. 12.5 minus 9.5. So what? I equals to class in I equal to 3. So what we have got? You see, this is the median class, this is the median frequency, this is the cumulative frequency before the median class, and the gap is the I means size of the median class. What is this? This is, see, just recall the problem. It is n by 2, the median lies in the group 9.5 and 12.5. L1 is the lower class boundary of the median class, that is 9.5. C is the cumulative frequency of class before the median class, the 27. This is FM. FM means frequency of the median class, that is 35. And also I means size of the median class, that is gap between two boundaries, lower boundaries and upper boundaries. That is 12.5 minus 9.5, that is 3. Okay. This is the problem. Now understood? I think you have understood. Okay, this is the problem. This is L1. Now understood? This is FM. This is C. This is N. And this is N by 2. Okay. This. Now, we will put all this value in the formula. Now putting all the values in the formula. Okay, putting all the values L1 plus N by 2 minus C FM. Just recall the values. That was 9.5. N by 2 was what? 54. C was 27. I is 3. And FM is 35. Now calculating this, we will get 2.31. What is the result? Is 11.81. So median lies, median is, therefore the median is 11.81. What I told you earlier, that median values lies in the class boundary 9.5 to 12.5. here the result is 11.81. It is in between 9.5 and 12.5. In this way, we can calculate the value of median for continuous series. I hope you enjoyed the class. Lastly, I would say, stay at home and stay safe. Thank you for watching this video.